today. Welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all having a good day, evening, morning, wherever you are in the world. In today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you a simple flare picture here. It's a very simple dress. I don't know if you guys can see it very well. Just a simple dress I'll be making with this measurement here. So we are going to be needing our measurement tape, our lovely African print fabric, our chalk, our rulers, and scissors. Okay guys, let's start. So what I have done, I have folded the fabric lengthwise, because if you fold the fabric, so this is the fabric, you can see that from here of the fabric to the other end, it's not long enough. The length of the dress is 60. So the measurement we need for this particular dress, we need a bust measurement, the waist measurement, the shoulder measurement, shoulder to waist measurement, the length of the dress, and the length of the sleeve, the hem, the elbow. It's a short sleeve. So if we are going to use here of the fabric, it's not going to be long enough. So we are going to use, going to fold it the lengthwise. So on the selvage end, we're going to fold it. Just let my hands run across. So fold it in a triangular shape. Dress, in order to achieve the flare correctly, we fold it in a triangular shape, and for the flare to flare properly, when you fold it into a triangular shape like this, you're actually folding it into a bias, so it's cut on the bias. Okay, so lay the fabric out properly. And now we can mark all the measurements down. So the length of the dress, as I said, is 60. If you minus 19, because shoulder to waist is 19. If you minus 19 from 60, you get 41. So we are going to take the length first, 41. So we'll measure. I measure it from the top of the fabric here. I measure 41. 41 plus half an inch to join it to the top. 1 inch to fold it, to hem it. So that's 42 and a half. So from this point here, from the top of the tape as well, you have to mark where you start, because you are going to mark the waist measurement here. On the other side, that's where you measure 42 and a half. Okay guys, and now we can take our ruler and just draw a straight line across. Or rather a curved line. You can draw a straight line as well. Straighten line first, then later on I'll curve it at the tip. So I'll draw a straight line across. So from here to here is 42 and a half, because the length of the dress is 60. and I just drew a straight line across. So on this side, I'm going to be marking down the waist measurement here. I'll just draw a straight line across where I start the 42 measurement from. So from this point here, I'm going to take the waist measurement. The waist divided by 4 is 11.5. So I'm going to mark 11.45 down. 11.5 down. It's 11.5 plus 1.5 inches. So the whole of this is 1.5 inches. So plus 1.5 inches. Okay, in this particular style, you don't really need the person's hip measurement, but you can take the hip if you want, but it's not really necessary because from the waist down, it's a flare-free dress from the waist down. So the hip is not really necessary, but you can take the hip measurement if you want to, it's not really necessary. So just so you know the wideness of the bottom, I'm just going to measure the bottom across so you know the wideness I used. Or folded, I used 21.5. So the fabric is folded. So I've used 21.5. So if you open the fabric out, that should be 43 altogether, which I think is wide enough. And that is almost the whole fabric at the end here. So all I need to do now is cut it out and then take this and cut the back. Front of the dress. I'm going to take this and cut the back before I shape the bottom side so it's not pointing. At the moment it's pointing. Okay guys, I'm going to cut the back now. I'm just going to take the front. I'm going to cut two of the front. Two of the front will make up the back. So I'm going to just lay the back, the front. Just lay it on the fabric. Don't forget I fold the fabric into a triangle shape. And then I cut it out. I'm going to take this and cut another one again because there is a zip allowance at the back. So I'm going to cut another one and I want the flare to be a bit more fuller. Okay guys, I'm going to show you how I cut the front and back. There's already a 2-inch zip allowance over here. That's the back, that's the front. It's just a simple round neck. So first of all, you take the shoulder measurement. The shoulder divided by 2 is 8.5. That's from the shoulder to the armhole point or the armpit point. It's 9.5. And then just draw a straight line from that point. Draw another straight line across to the other side. Remember, our shoulder is not straight, so come down by 1 inch at the shoulder point. Come down by 1 inch. So for the neck, I'm going to be using 4, the wideness of the neck. I'm going to 4 inches wide, and for the depth I'm going to be using 6 inches. For the back I'm going to be using 2 inches, the depth of the back. So now I just take my ruler and connect the mark. Also, I connect the mark for the neck. Connect the back one as well, the back neck. That's why you use your curved rollers. You need it. So now we are going to be taking the measurement for the bust and the waist. First, of all, before we start, we are going to mark down the bust point. So shoulder to bust point is 13. So you know where the bust point, the bust starts from. Just draw a straight line across. So from there, the bust divided by 4 is 12. Plus 2 inches sewing allowance. The remaining is the waist. The waist divided by 4 is 11.5. Plus 3 inches sewing allowance. Reason is because I'm going to put in a dart. Okay, so all you need to do is to take your ruler and just connect the lines. So from the remaining of the ham hole, which is your chest, you are going to get a midpoint of 8.5. To get the midpoint, just take a measurement tape and connect it to 8.5. Press it so it gives you a crest. And whatever the midpoint, whatever crest you give you, that's the midpoint. So you just mark it there. And then from there, you take a curved ruler and mark it. And just draw a nice curved shape for your armhole. Check everything make sure everything is accurate. Okay, so now you just cut it out. Cut the back one out first. Neck of the back. Guys, now you can cut the front neck. Okay, so that's how it looks like. Just a simple. Here. I'm going to cut the lining. I take this and cut the lining and the back as well. I take it and use it to cut the lining. So all I need to do is to slit the back open. And that's for the zip. Back by zip, so you slip it open for the zip, and the zip goes in there. So I'll take it as well and cut the lining. So I'll show you how to cut the sleeve now. It's a very simple straight sleeve, but I'm going to show you the easy method I use to cut my sleeve. Into two at the moment. And then I fold it again. So when I do it that way, it gives me the two sleeves. I take the length of the sleeve, and also if you divide your bust by 12 and your bicep, your hand sleeve round measurement, if you divide it into two, the length of it plus 1.5 inches sewing allowance, that's what you should cut out. That's the wideness of it. If not, it's not going to be enough. So this is 13, and I think this is going to be perfectly okay for what I want. So I just cut it out. Okay, so now I'm going to take the length of the sleeve first. Before I do that, I just use a chopper and do 1 inch guideline. The ruler. From the 1 inch guideline point, I take the length of the sleeve. The length of the sleeve is 18 plus 1.5 inches, so you want. And that's 19. Can use the selvage edge for the ends. So if I want to do that, I move it down a bit. So I start the guideline from here. 19.5. Okay, so I start the guideline from here because I'm going to be using the selvage edge as the hem. I'm going to hem it in instead of overlocking the hem. Okay, so from here, all I do is that you divide your bust by 12. It gives you, like in my case, my bust divided by 12, or the person's measurement bust divided by 12 is 4. So I just mark 4 here. Mark 4 there. So from this point, this is the quickest way I do my sleeve. I don't want to go into the detail of how to draft the sleeve. I already got a video of how to do that. So from this point, I freehand it from here to meet this point. So I freehand it from this point, the guideline. And when I get here, I draw like a C shape. You can see what I've done there. So from here, I freehand like an S shape. I freehand it to meet the 4 here. Towards the bottom here, I draw a bit of a C shape or an S shape to the point there. So from the elbow, the first measurement, the elbow is 17 divided by 2. 8.5, so I mark 8.5 down here. Plus 1 inch of sewing allowance. So from that point, I connect from here to this point here. So from this point, I connect to this point. You can use your hip curl ruler, which is very good. You take a hip curl ruler. Take it to the machine and sew it, and I'll show you the finished outcome of the dress. And also, I decided not to put the zip all the way down to the flare section of the dress. I'm only putting the zip halfway. Thanks guys for watching. Please, if you like this video, like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thanks, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.